he thinks Hillary Clinton is going to be the Democratic nominee. What do you think?
I think she will be. I know her very well. She's very talented, and she has a husband that I also like very much. I think she's going to get the nomination rather easily.
And then the president goes on to say this. He says, I think our candidate can beat her, but it's going to be a tough race. I will work to see to it that a Republican wins, and therefore don't accept the premise that a Democrat will win. I truly think the Republicans will hold the White House. You agree with him on that?
Well, I mean, the whole thing is about him. He's been so bad that I think probably a Democrat has a huge advantage. Now, crazy things happen in life, but a Democratic candidate, whoever wins, is going to have a huge advantage because of Bush. People don't like him. People think he's been a horrible president, possibly the worst in the history of this country.
You believe that?
Oh, he's been a terrible president.
You think he's the worst in the history of the United States?
I don't think he can get much worse. Why? I mean, who's worse? Give me a couple of names. Who could be worse?
Well, because in the last interview we did in March, you said he was the worst.
Well, at least I'm consistent.
But and the reason you think he's the worst is?
Well, just look at this country. We've gone from this tremendous power that was respected all over the world to somewhat of a laughingstock, and all of a sudden people are talking about China and India and other places, even from an economic standpoint. America's come down a long way. The United States has come down a long way, and it's very, very sad. We're not respected. The war in Iraq has been a total catastrophe, and the day we leave, it's going to be the ultimate revolution, and that's going to be it. Nothing we're going to do about it. It's a shame. We've hundreds of billions of dollars, and much more importantly, the soldiers, these brave men and women that went over there, and they come back with no arms, no legs, no face.
Or they don't come back.
And the Iraqis that are, I mean, you know, a million people probably, if you really think about it. You know, they say they drop bombs on a city, and they say, oh, nobody was hurt. Oh, really? You know, nobody was hurt? No, the whole thing's been a big lie, from reading 60 books a year. Do you think he reads 60 books a year? I don't think so.
Very important. The president says he would be a political asset to the Republicans next year, as opposed to being a political liability. You think President Bush next year will be an asset or a liability to the Republican presidential nominee, whoever that is?
I think President Bush has to go into a corner and hide if a Republican's going to get elected. There's no way he's an asset. He's a huge liability, and he's going to have to do a big, big hiding act if a Republican's going to win.
Because a lot of pundits out there say if the Democrats can't win the White House this time around, they might as well just hang up their cleats or whatever and go back into the dugout.
Well, they said that last time, and John Kerry didn't do it. And amazingly, he didn't do it. I couldn't understand how that could have happened, but he didn't do it. No, I think President Bush is a huge liability, and he should just go into a corner and just say, okay, that's it, I'm finished, it's over. Or, in my opinion, if he comes out for somebody, it's a huge liability.
If he comes out for Rudy Giuliani, for example?
Hey, look, I don't think that President Bush is in any way, shape, or form an asset for the person that's running for president. He's been a disaster.
Think about Hillary Clinton's coming out with a new health care plan the other day. Obviously, she had a bad experience back in 93 and 94 when she was first lady.
I think it was very good. I think she came out with an idea. It's a very, very complex set of things going on right now in terms of health care, but she came out with an idea. It sounds like a pretty good idea, and a lot of people like it and embraced it, and she learned a lot from her previous encounter.
You 6 months ago when we spoke, you didn't think Barack Obama had enough experience yet to be president of the United States. You've had 6 months to think about that. You still feel that way?
I think he's a very effective guy. I don't think he has enough experience.
Would he be a good running mate?
Possibly. It could happen. A lot of people are saying that's what's going to happen.
You think that Hillary Clinton should pick him?
I don't think that, but I think it's something that could happen.
Because you hire and fire people all the time. If you saw Barack Obama, would you hire him?
Oh, I think he's a very talented guy. I mean, look at the job he's done. He's come from nowhere, and look at, you know, he's still getting pretty good numbers in the polls. I mean, he hasn't gone away. Some people have gone away. They're gone. They failed. He has not gone away by any stretch of the imagination. I guess he still has a little bit of a chance, but I think Hillary is going to take it, and I think Hillary is very, very capable. The last thing this country needs is a lazy president.